Hello students, last time you have seen the concept of polarization. Polarization is the phenomenon of the light having the vibration lies along only one plane. By means of some devices or the method, then it is called as polarization. Polarization is the light which contains the vibration lies along only one plane. The unpolarized light, that is the natural light or the what we call as the ordinary light, just like our bulb, MSB bulb, or the light coming from the tube, or the light coming from the sun, can be regarded as the natural light or the ordinary light, and those lights is nothing but the unpolarized light. And that light can be polarized by means of here the many methods we have seen, by the method of reflection, by the method of refraction, and by the method of double refraction. Today we will see here the what is the double refraction and the characteristics of this phenomenon and how this phenomenon leads to the polarization. So here, if the unpolarized light, this is the unpolarized light here, unpolarized light, and it is indicated by the line and dot together, line and dot together here. So this is the unpolarized light here, which is coming from the natural sources and which can be indicated by line and dot together, line and dot together, line and dot together on the direction of the propagation of the light. When such an unpolarized light is incident, twice passed through certain typical crystals like quartz, calcite, tourmaline, etc., then it is seen that we are getting two refracted beams. Instead of one, we are getting two refracted beams. The phenomenon is known as what here? The double refraction here. So the phenomenon, instead of the single refracted beam, if we can use the ordinary glass, etc., we are getting single refracted beam. But these are the typical crystals which occur in nature, and so quartz, calcite, tourmaline, etc. And when unpolarized light is incident on this here, the two refracted beams are observed here. Now the characteristics. And this phenomenon is known as double refraction. Why it is called as double refraction? We are getting two refracted beams, therefore it is called as double refraction here. Now, the characteristics of this phenomenon. The characteristics or the properties. Characteristics. The first characteristics. Now, out of these two rays, out of these two refracted rays, one which obeys normal laws of optics, normal laws of optics, the out of two refracted beams, one which obeys normal laws is known as the ordinary. It is known as what here? The O ray or the ordinary here. See, out of two refracted rays, one which obeys the normal laws of optics like the Snell's law, etc., then such a ray is known as the ordinary ray or O ray. Why the other, which does not obey any laws of normal laws of the optics, therefore it is called as extraordinary, particularly which does not obey, which does not follow the laws of the optics, and therefore that ray or the ray is known as which does not follow the laws, which is known as what here? The extraordinary or E ray. So out of two refracted beams, one which obeys normal laws of optics is known as just the ordinary by the symbol normal laws obeys. While other ray does not follow the laws of the optics is known as what here? The extraordinary, or it is simply called as E ray. This is the first property. The second property is here. It is seen that the refractive index of the ordinary ray, it is mu is nothing but the symbol for the refractive index. Refractive index of the ordinary ray, that is mu O, is found to be equal to constant. It is found to be equal to what here? The constant. And it does not dependent on the direction of the incident ray. So this is the incident ray. It makes an angle something theta, or if we can draw here the normal, then that can be regarded as the angle of incidence. This angle of incidence can be changed. The direction of the incident ray will be here, 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 like this, or here, 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 like this. If the incident direction of the unpolarized light is changed here, it is seen that the refractive index of the O ray does not change here. It remains to be what here the constant, while it is seen that the refractive index of the external ray, it is represented as mu e, and it is found to be not constant. It varies. It depends on the direction of incident rays. It depends on the direction of the incident beam, incident and polarized light. When its direction is changed, the refractive index of the E ray changes or the varies. While the refractive index of O ray is found to be equal to constant. This is the another property. The third property is nothing but here. Out of this incident ray, there is particular direction along which light is incident. This incident direction can be changed. We can change here. This direction can be changed in the angle varies from theta to 90 degree here. There is a particular direction along which this light is incident here. No double reflection phenomena is observed. That particular direction is known as the optic axis. So optic axis is the particular direction. This is called as the optic axis. Optic axis. So it is the particular direction along which light is incident. No double reflection phenomena is observed. We are getting single reflected phenomena here out of these two. It means here, in other words, the velocity of O and E ray. Optic axis, in this case, velocity of O ray here is nothing but Vo suppose, and velocity of extraordinary is nothing but Ve suppose. Then it is seen that along the optic axis, both the rays are traveling along the same direction. So optic axis is the particular direction along which the velocity of the ordinary and the velocity of the extraordinary are same. These velocities, when equal, then their direction is known as optic axis. Optic axis plays the important role as far as the polarization and the double refraction phenomena is concerned here. So this is the optic axis. Now, fourth one is nothing but here. The vibrations of the E rays, it is seen that here the vibrations of E rays are always parallel to the optic axis. Vibration of E rays are always parallel to optic axis, parallel to optic axis. While the vibrations of the O rays are always here the perpendicular to optic axis. With respect to what here? This is with respect to optic axis. Vibrations of E rays are always parallel to the optic axis, while the vibrations of the E rays are perpendicular to the optic axis. In the concept of polarization, we have seen that the vibrations are comparable to the plane of paper. Now we will see here the vibrations are comparable with respect to the optic axis. Optic axis is the particular direction along which light is incident. No double refraction phenomena is observed here. That direction is known as optic axis. Or optic axis is the axis along which velocity of O ray and velocity of E ray are same. What will happen is that here, when unpolarized light is incident here, it breaks into two, O and E rays. This and travel in the crystal with different velocities here. The optic axis is that direction along which the velocity are same. We are getting, so Vo is equal to Ve. So the next property is nothing but here, the vibrations of the E rays are always parallel to the axis, and parallel vibrations are represented by the line, only lines on the direction of the propagation of the light here. So this is the E ray. While the vibrations of the, if the vibrations are perpendicular to the optic axis, it is represented by dot on the direction of the propagation of the light. Therefore, this is the O ray. In some cases, this O ray will be lies to the upper side, E ray will be lies to the below side, depending on here the whether which crystal is used. And we next after we will see the type of crystal structure, and in that we are getting that idea here. So this is the next property. The fifth property is nothing but here. It is also seen that here the extraordinary ray and the ordinary ray are both are plane polarized. Both the rays are plane polarized. Plane polarized in the perpendicular, mutually perpendicular directions, or in the mutually perpendicular planes. Here, the E rays has the vibrations parallel to the optic axis. Means the vibrations of the E rays lies along only one plane here, parallel to the optic axis. While the vibrations of the O ray lies in the
perpendicular to the optic axis here. If the optic axis is considered as this here, the U vibrations we are getting like this parallel, and O vibrations we are getting in the plane perpendicular to the optic axis. So, and both the therefore the vibrations lies along only one plane, therefore it is plane polarized. Here is also vibrations lies along only one plane, different plane, but in one plane, therefore it is also plane polarized. So both the rays are plane polarized in the perpendicular, mutually perpendicular planes here. So this is the another property, as both the rays are plane polarized, but in the perpendicular, mutually perpendicular planes as far as the planes are concerned. And six, last property is nothing but here. It is seen that the images produced by E ray and O ray are found to be the, as far as the intensity of the image produced by E ray and O ray is concerned, then the emission intensity is found to be equal to same. So these are some of the characteristics or the features of the double refraction phenomenon. What is double refraction phenomenon? When unpolarized light is incident on the some crystals here or passed through some crystals, two reflected beams are observed. The phenomenon is known as double refraction. Due to two reflected beams, the name is given double refraction. And out of two rays, the one which obeys normal laws of the optics is known as O ray, and while the other does not obey the normal laws of the optics is known as extraordinary. It is seen that the refractive index of the O ray is constant, while the refractive index of E ray is not constant. It depends on the direction of the incident ray. If the direction of the incident ray is varies, the E ray found to be changed or it varies. But whatever the direction of the incident ray may be found to be is called constant. There is a particular direction along which light is incident. No double refraction phenomena is observed. We are not getting the two refracted beams. We are getting only the single refracted beam. That direction is known as the optic axis. Or in other words, the optic axis is one for which the velocity of O ray or the ordinary ray is equal to velocity of the extraordinary ray. As far as vibrations are concerned, the vibrations of the E rays are always parallel to the optic axis. The vibrations of the O ray are always perpendicular to the optic axis. It is seen that both the rays gives rise to, both the light, E light as well as O light are plane polarized in the mutually perpendicular planes. And lastly, both produces the images of the what here? The same intensity or the equal intensity. So these are the characteristics of the double refraction phenomena. Now we will see types of double refracted crystals. Now types of double refracted crystals next. Types of double refracting crystal. It is seen that there are two types of the double refracting crystal. One is nothing but negative double refracting crystal. Negative double refracting crystal. While the other is nothing but here, the positive double refracting crystal. Positive double refracting crystal. Here. Now, negative double refracting crystal. The negative double refracting crystal. Negative double refracting crystal, DRC we will say in short here, negative double refracting crystal. The crystal is said to be, this is first type here, this is first type, this is second type here. So the negative double refracting crystal is said to be negative if refractive index of O ordinary is greater than the refractive index of the extraordinary. If we can getting like this situation, refractive index of O ray is greater than the refractive index of E ray, then the double refracted crystal is said to be negative. We are knowing, but here the refractive index, we are knowing the formula for the refractive index, mu is equal to velocity of light in here divided by the velocity of light in here divided by the velocity of ray in medium. In what here? In medium. Velocity of light in here divided by velocity when light is incident here, it is coming from the air. This is the crystal. While traveling through the crystal, the velocity changes. So the ratio velocity of light in air divided by velocity of
ray in medium is gives rise to refractive index. So for the mu, for mu, we can apply the definition. It is equal to mu is equal to what here? The velocity of light in air. It is represented by Va divided by the velocity of O ray. Now here O ray in the medium, it is represented by Vo. It is equal to Vo here. Why the refractive index of the extraordinary can be calculated here? Mu E is equal to velocity of light in air, that is Va, divided by velocity of E ray now in medium, that is equal to Ve. And now consider here, consider the ratio. We will consider this ratio. Consider ratio. Consider mu O, refractive index of O ray is greater than the refractive index of E ray in case of the negative crystal. Negative double plane crystal is one for which mu O is greater than V. We will consider this mu O is greater than V. So we will put these values, which implies here Va, Va divided by Vo is greater than or equal to Va divided by V, like this. So which implies Va, Va get cancels here, we will, and we are getting for negative double plane crystal Vo is greater than 1 upon V. So like this we will. And when we change this, when this 1 upon V, we will take the reciprocal of this equation. We are getting Vo here, we are getting Ve here. And remember, this sign changes your name. So Vo is less than Ve. Means here, for the negative double refractive crystal, velocity of O ray is always less than the velocity of E ray. Means if suppose, and for example, here the calcite, if suppose this is the calcite crystal, what will happen is that here this is the calcite crystal, which is good example of the negative double refracting crystal here. What will happen is that when unpolarized light is incident, it is represented by line and dot together, it is represented by line and dot together, it breaks into two here. So remember like this. And we are getting two refracted beams here. Now, the velocity of, you have to remember that in this case, refractive index of O ray is greater than the refractive index of E ray. And generally, for the practical, we can calculate that mu is equal to sine. We are knowing sine A plus delta M. Which is formula, mu is equal to sine A M. Delta M divided by 2 whole divided by sine A by 2, sine A by 2. This is the formula for calculating practically calculation of the refractive index, sine A plus delta M divided by 2. And if we can use here, instead of this, we can use here the prism. Here, we can use here the prism with base like this here and incident like this here. And we are getting two refracted beams here. We are getting two refracted beams. And the angle, this is the initial direction. This angle can be regarded at here. The O ray we are getting here, E ray is getting here. In case of what here? The negative double refracting crystal we are getting like this from this situation. In order to have the mu O is greater than the mu E, the angle of the O ray must be greater than the what here? The angle of the E ray. And therefore, O ray lies below than the E from the initial direction. From the initial direction, we are getting two spectrums. One is called as the extraordinary spectrum, other is called as ordinary spectrum in case of the prism. And therefore, here we are getting dots, we have to write here like this. And the vibrations parallel means we have to draw the lines here. So this is, and this is the E ray first of all. And here is nothing but O ray traveling towards this here. Here is also we have to draw the parallel lines. Here is also we have to draw the perpendicular vibrations. And both the rays are traveling. When unpolarized light is incident here, this point can be act as a source of two rays, one for O ray, other for the E ray, and they are further traveling in this medium. It is seen that Vo is less than Ve, means Ve is coming out from the crystal first. And then because velocity of the O ray is less than here, the velocity of O ray is less than the velocity of the E ray, and therefore O ray here, there is lagging of the what here, the output rays, your output propagating rays O and E rays, there will be lagging of the phases because of the velocity of the O ray is less than the velocity of E ray. E ray travels faster, O ray travels slower, so E rays come out from the crystal first and then this. So we are getting like this situation, or the figure will be like this. So this is the negative double refracting crystal, and the example, good example is what here, the calcite. Now as far as another crystal is concerned here, type is nothing but positive crystal. In case of the positive double refracting crystal here, the double refracting crystal is said to be positive if we are getting the condition if mu o is less than the mu. So opposite we are getting the condition here, mu o is greater than the mu, but in case of the positive double refracting crystal we are getting mu o is less than the mu. And with similar manner, in the similar manner we will put, consider like this, we are getting here the velocity of O ray in this case is found to be greater than the velocity of E ray. In case of this velocity of the O ray travels slower in the medium while E ray travels faster. In this case O ray travels faster than the, what here, the opposite case here. And so if we have to draw the figure, so if suppose this is the prism which is made up of quartz is good example of the positive double refracting crystal. So the prism is made up of the quartz crystal, and if suppose this is the base, and if the unpolarized light is incident here, it is represented by line and dot together here, line and dot together here, then these points can be act as a source of two rays, the one for O ray, other for the E ray, you are getting like this, and they further travel. Here it is seen that here velocity of O ray is more, so O ray travels to our eyes first here, and then we are getting what here, the E ray O ray. So in this figure you see here, from initial position first spectrum we are getting E, then O, but in case of the quartz we are getting the like this situation. In order to fulfill this condition, mu o is less than the mu, we are getting here, we are getting perpendicular dot here, we are getting, while the parallel vibrations we will write like this, so we are getting like this situation. So opposite to this situation, so this is very important. So what we have seen is that here we have seen what is meant by double refraction. We have seen the features of the double refraction phenomena, six properties we have seen, and next we have seen the types of double refracting crystal. There are two types, negative double refracting crystal, for that mu o is greater than always mu e, means mu o is less than the phi, opposite condition in case of velocity we are getting, and the diagram should be like this. While the positive double refracting, second type, the positive double refracting crystal, for which refractive index of O ray is greater than the V. In other words, the velocity of O ray is always greater than the V. An example is quartz, there is nothing but calcite. So this is regarding the phenomenon of the double refraction and the types of the double refracting crystals. In the next lecture, we will see here, we will explain the double refraction phenomenon. How it can be explained actually, that we are going to study in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.